what we've learned so far is this goes from the very top, right? Sean Payton, I know I'm going to get his name wrong, Greg Williams, who was the defensive coordinator. Jonathan Vilma was the head of the defense. He was the player, the play caller. The play caller for the defensive team. Few other active team leaders. It wasn't just Jonathan Vilma, three other players as well. Two of whom I think are no longer even on the Saints. Right. And they're all getting into trouble right now. Is there this? Should we be making a distinction between what the coaches are doing on the bounty program and what the players were doing?
Well, that's definitely the side that Roger Goodell has come down on, and he's been more harsh with those suspensions and penalties, I think, because when this initially was being investigated, he came to the coaches and to the people in the organization and said, is this happening? And their response was no. And so I think he's come down harder on them because not only were there repeated offenses in his eyes, but also that he thought they'd been untruthful.
Right.
But the
players had been untruthful. So, for example, there was a suggestion, I think in the piece that you wrote, or I don't know if Goodell said this, there was a suggestion that when approached, when Vilma and when some of the other players were approached and said, hey, what's going on here? Were you part of the bounty program? Maybe that they didn't cover it up, but they weren't exactly telling it like it was.
Sure, and that was the case with Sean Payton as well.
Oh, is that right?
With Mickey Loomis. So that's why I think you've seen him come down and why those were actually handed down first, the organizational penalties and then to the players.
Are the New Orleans Saints kind of out of it this season? I mean, even if they get a temporary coach, you know, I mean, taking out somebody like Vilma is really a severe penalty for a team when you're basically removing the leader of their defensive side of the ball. Is this basically it? Is this kind of a lost season de facto for the Saints?
It'll be a test. I'm not sure if it'll be, you know, if you can write them off completely. They're not really a strong defensive team anyway. They're 24th in the league in total defense. They're first in the league in offense. And so, the irony is you're taking away something that they're already weak at, and maybe it's not hurting them as much as if you were to take away a Drew Brees, who's one of the best quarterbacks in the league and a top flight offense. So, you know, because it's the defense that's being alleged of having done all these things, they're the ones that are being penalized for it. The offense isn't going to lose anybody like that, but you do lose the coach who calls the offensive plays and stuff like that.
And it affects the team's morale
and the
kind of the team spirit in the city and all that kind of stuff. Haven't the Saints team over the last few years, they became a bit of a poster child for the NFL. I mean, coming, you know, after the Hurricane Katrina, the NFL kind of went out of its way to kind of hold up the development of the Saints. I think there was even a question whether or not Saints were going to leave New Orleans after Katrina. I think I'm getting that right.
Sure.
And they sort of held them up, and then they won the Super Bowl, and so they were like this hero, and then go from hero to goat in a couple of years. It's kind of a mighty fall.
Sure. I mean, it was pretty easy story to wrap your arms around after Katrina and everything that happened with that. An organization that just had never even been that far, had never done well. They, you know, for years were called the Aints rather than the Saints because of how poorly they played and all the images of the fans that wear bags on their heads. But a quick turnaround, and now, you know, I'm sure they're hoping that it won't be a quick fall, but it could be that.
Final question. Is that it? Are we going to see any further repercussions on the Saints, or are we going to discover that there was, by the way, there were other teams out there with the bounty programs? What do you think the odds of that are, Chris?
Sure. Well, there won't be any more player suspensions on the Saints because of this issue. They're actually being looked at for all sorts of other stuff. There was a question of whether or not the general manager had the ability to eavesdrop on other teams' communications up in his box. So that's being looked at. I'm not sure if the NFL started looking into it yet, but we'll see in terms of the other teams. I don't think that there's a way for the NFL to even possibly look at all these teams.
Will Vilma and the other Saints, some of whom are no longer on the Saints, will they appeal the decision?
They've got nothing to lose, so I would not be surprised if you see an appeal from these
Chris guys. Herring, thank you very much. Yes. Reporter for the Wall Street Journal, has the misfortune, in my book, of covering the Jets.